हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी लर्न स्टैंडर्ड 6 जनरल साइंस। इन दैट लेसन नंबर 3 इज डाइवर्सिटी इन लिविंग थिंग्स एंड देयर क्लासिफिकेशंस। एंड इन दिस लेसन, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी लर्न डाइवर्सिटी एंड क्लासिफिकेशन इन प्लांट्स, एंड टुडे वी लर्न डाइवर्सिटी एंड क्लासिफिकेशन इन एनिमल्स। सी ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक पेज नंबर 23, diversity and classification in animals. Different animals have developed different shapes to survive in the environment, and there is a great variety in the body structure of animals too. The amoeba that cannot be seen with our eyes, the huge elephant, the small snail, the fish that swims in water, a kite that flies in the sky, and butterflies that flit around flowers, a house lizard that crawls on a wall are all animals, and each has different characteristics. So what we observe that students, there is great variety in the animals, and animals have body parts like a head, a neck, a torso, a tail and limbs for movement, and they have various organ systems which carry on various functions inside their body, and in this respect too there is a lot of diversity in animals. See, there is one question for you: what are the differences in the body structure of animals like snake, lizard, tiger, a fish, an eagle, a hen, a crab, a housefly, an earthworm, a crocodile, and a grasshopper? See, what are the differences in the body structure of these animals? And out of all above animals, tiger is a mammal, and it has head, neck, torso, tail, and two pairs of limbs for locomotion. Snake, lizard and crocodile are reptiles. Snake has limbless body. Lizard and crocodile have smaller limbs in comparison of to their bulky bodies. There is no prominent distinction between head and torsos, as there is no distinct neck present in these animals. And fish is completely aquatic animal, and it has streamlined body covered with scales. It swims with the help of fins and breathes with gills. An eagle and a hen are birds. The body is covered with feathers, and both have wings. But eagle can fly at great heights due to its powerful wings. Hens cannot fly to heights and is usually seen picking at the ground level. An earthworm has segmented body which is slippery and tapering, and there is no distinct head, torso or limbs in such invertebrate animal, and it does not even have a vertebral column. Housefly and grasshopper are both insects, and both of them have 6 pair of walking legs. The hand legs of grasshopper are very strong, and thus it can jump to a longer distance. And housefly has delicate wings, and thus keeps on hovering over a small area. In both of these insects, there is head, thorax, and abdomen. And crab's body is covered with a thick and hard shell. And crab has 5 pair of walking legs. The first pair of these legs is modified to form pincer or cella, which is used for capturing a prey. And these animals is seen in the coastal part of the seas or banks of the rivers. And the structure of the body is very different in it. Okay, these are all diversity among these animals. We see a variety in animals with respect to their food as well as, since animals depend on others for their food and they are found in places where food is available. And different animals have different method of obtaining and eating food. This to lead to differences in their body structure. See, there are 3.6 figure number diversity in animals and there shows various animals. And observe the animal in your surrounding. There is activity for you. And make a list of their names and complete the following table on the basis of information obtained and discuss in the class. Okay, there is a column given and you observe animals in your surrounding and complete that column. You take whatever 8, 9, 10 name of the animals and what is their food, how do they eat, where do they live, the special feature that you found and complete that chart. Okay, and you will not see all animals in your own surroundings. Why it is, which are other animals that you know of but have not seen, and collect all information about them using the above table. Okay, this is activity for you. Now page number next, that is 24. See, on page number 24 there is again one activity. Take a drop of water from a puddle and place it on a glass slide and observe it under a microscope. What do you see? And when a drop of water from puddle is seen under a microscope, innumerable microbes can be seen moving about in it. And you will see the continuously moving amoeba. Paramecium is also a unicellular animals like the amoeba. And horse, a bear, a tortoise are multicellular animals. What is the chain of bones in the center of our back called? Yes, the chain of bones in the center of the body is called a vertebral column. And animals with a vertebral column and those without it form two hoofs known as vertebrates and invertebrates respectively. Snakes, birds, fish and kangaroos, as also humans, are vertebrate animals. Animals such as snails, cockroaches, earthworms do not have a vertebral column and therefore they can invertebrate. They are invertebrate animals. Name some animals which lay eggs and other which give birth to their young ones. All the birds lay eggs. The snakes and lizard also lay eggs. All the mammals such as cat, dog, lion, tiger and human beings give birth to their young ones. We have learned that producing another living thing like oneself is called a reproduction. A hen lays egg and hatches them, and after a few days you young chicks hatch up out of the eggs. And a cow gives birth to a calf. Before that, the calf grows within the cow's body. And according to the method of reproduction, animals are classified into two types, namely oviparous animals which lay eggs and viviparous animals which give birth to their young ones. Where are the animals, namely a horse, a bear, a tortoise, an alligator, a fish, a deer, and a frog to be found? Yes, horse, a bear, and a deer are terrestrial animals. Out of these, horse is a domestic animal. Bear and deer are wild animals. Fish is completely aquatic animal. It cannot survive out of the water. And frog is an amphibian. It can stay both in water as well as on the land. And it can breathe in water with the help of skin. And on land, it breathes with lungs. Alligator and tortoise can swim in water and can also crawl on the land, but they cannot breathe inside the water. Okay, these are variety in animals. Now, according to their habitat, animals are usually classified into terrestrial and aquatic animals. However, animals like a frog, salamander, toad live in both places, namely land and water. Therefore, they are called amphibious animals. A kite, an eagle, a crow, a butterfly, a honeybee all fly in the air, though they live in different places. And these animals are said to be an aerial mode of life. See, there is one picture and also shown varieties of their living. Then use your brain power. What are the different criteria used to classify animals? Yes, what are the criteria? That is aquatic animals, different, amphibians, terrestrial, any aerial. These are the different classification of animals doing. Now, at the last of this chapter, always remember that in the living world, a lot of diversity is seen both in the animals and plants, and every plant and animal is unique, and we should all make efforts to conserve this diversity in the living world. Okay, it is most important. Then what we have learned in this whole chapter, that is, we have studied about the diversity of plants and animals, and plants are classified on the basis of their height and the shape of stems, period of life cycle and habitat, while the animals are classified on the basis of the cell structure, vertebral column, method of reproduction and habitats. Okay, so student, we learn lesson number 3, that the diversity in living things, plants and animals. Okay student, so today we will stop here. Okay, bye bye.